Hello, this is Stacy Black, and I'm here at Bossier Parish Community College on the open campus, and I'm here to review some basic skills from Algebra 2, Math 099. This first module is about vocabulary of polynomials. In today's lesson, we will talk about the vocabulary words you will hear throughout the semester that you need to understand in order to do algebra. So I'm going to turn to our notes. And on our first set of notes, we talk about the basic definition in algebra. In algebra, we talk about putting together terms. A term is either a number, for example, 5. A term could be a letter, for example, the letter A. Or a term could be a product of a number or a letter. And remember, the word product means to multiply. So if you look, 5A, which is 5 times A, is a number and letter side by side connected by multiplication. We would call that one term. In real life, think of it's one term as one thought. So when I wrote the number 5, we could all imagine $5. If I write 5A, that's one thought. That's like 5 apples. If you look again, I have another term, 5A squared. Again, because that's connected by multiplication, it's one thought. But 5A squared doesn't look like 5A, so it's something totally different. So 5A may have been 5 apples. 5A squared is 5 apricots. Now, we do have a problem, so let's go up here to the board and let's explain it. In our definition, we have A divided by 5. Well, that doesn't fit. The definition says a term should be connected by multiplication. So what we have to remember is, first of all, in front of this variable A, there is a number. That number is understood to be 1. And if we also have to review the fact that we all know from arithmetic, multiplication and division are equal operations, which means anything that's connected by division can be rewritten as multiplication. So think about it in real life. If I had $100 and I was giving you half, that means I'm taking my $100 and dividing it by 2. So the same thing. In algebra, A divided by 5 can be rewritten as 1/5 times A. An apple divided into 5 pieces means you're getting 1/5 of an apple. Now, what's important to understand is we called these terms in 98, algebra 1. In 99, algebra 2, we also can call these monomials. And the prefix mono means one. So one term is called a monomial. Now, we can build on that. If we have 2 terms, we call it a binomial. Prefix bi means 2, just like a bicycle has 2 wheels. If we have 3 terms, we call it a trinomial, just like the prefix tri means 3 for a tricycle, 3 wheels. And if we have 4 or more terms, we call it a polynomial, because the prefix poly means many. So let's look at another example. If I write 5a plus 3b minus c plus 4, you would notice that there are 4 terms. 1, 2, 3, 4. The terms are separated by addition and subtraction symbols. Think of it as this. Every term is a thought. So there are 4 thoughts up here. 5 apples plus 3 bananas minus a coconut plus $4. So if you could visualize 4 different things, you have 4 different monomials. Because there are 4 monomials up here, we call this a polynomial, many monomials. Okay, let's go back to our definitions. Important definitions. There's a word constant and there's the word coefficient. Constant means something that stays the same. So a constant is just a number. Coefficient is also a number, but it is in front of the variable connected by multiplication. So think of the prefix co in coefficient, like you would think about the prefix co in coworker. Coworker is somebody you work together with. So coefficient is a number that's going to work together with a variable. So let's go back to the board and look at this. If I go back to this polynomial, there is
a constant, and there are three coefficients. A constant is the number that's all by itself. That would be the 4. The 4 is your constant. But in this polynomial, we have three coefficients. We have three numbers that are working with variables. And you know they're working with them because they're right by them, connected by multiplication. So in this polynomial, we have three coefficients. Our first coefficient is 5. Our second coefficient is 3. And our third coefficient is in front of the C. It is understood to be an invisible 1, so that's -1. So just realize when you're working with algebra, you have coefficients, numbers in front of variables, and constants, numbers that stand alone.
Okay, let's look at one more definition. The next definition I would like to look at is the word degree. Every polynomial is said to have a degree. The degree is the value of the highest exponent.
This definition will become very important later in this course.
So we're going to go look at this polynomial together. I have the polynomial 5x cubed plus 4x minus 1. That polynomial has three monomials, three terms. So I could actually call this a trinomial. Every monomial in that trinomial has an exponent. The first one, it's obvious. The exponent is right here. It is a 3. The second one, it's not obvious. This is 4x. Well, every variable has an exponent. If it's not written, it's understood to be a 1. The third term, which is a constant, a number by itself, also has an exponent. But because you don't see a variable, there is no x, we write x to the 0. So if we were looking at these three monomials, our highest exponent is obviously the 3. We would say this trinomial is of degree 3. So to conclude our first lesson, we went over some basic vocabulary that you're going to hear throughout the semester. Hope you learned something. Thank you.